Hi, I am Hardik Naik from Engineering Guru Fanagenity YouTube channel. In this video, you will learn instantaneous center method for 4-bar chain mechanism. Here the one problem, 4-bar chain mechanism is given. So length of fixed link, that is 300 mm, link BC and CD equal to 360 mm, AD equal to 600 mm, angle BAD equal to 60 degree, the crank rotate uniformly at 100 rpm. So our goal is to locate all the instantaneous center and find the angular velocity of the link. Means here NAB is given 100 rpm. So from this we can find omega AB equal to 2 pi n by 60. So n equal to 100. So we can find omega AB equal to 10.47 radian per second. So angle is given. So in this problem, we have to locate all the instantaneous centers and we have to find angular velocity of link BC, that is omega BC. So here length of crank is given 300 mm. So convert into meter, that is 0.3. So velocity of point B of link AB, that is VB, because point A is fixed. So V equal to R omega, means omega AB into length of AB. Omega AB we already find, that 10.47, and OB equal to 0.3. So from this we can find the value of velocity of B equal to 3.141 meter per second. Now first draw space diagram. So assume the scale 600 mm equal to 6 centimeter. So for this 1 centimeter equal to 100 mm. So now take one random point and draw this AD link. The length is given 600 mm. So as per our scale, draw this line AD, link AD equal to 6 centimeter. Now here angle is given 60 degree and length of AB equal to 300 mm. So as per our scale, the length of this particular link is 3 centimeter. Now length of BC is given 360 mm. So take one arc at 3.6 centimeter. CD is also given 360. So as per scale, that value, that length equal to 3.6 centimeter. So from this D, take one arc that will intersect at this point. This point is called point C. Now simple join this BC link and this CD link. So our space diagram is ready. So this is called fixed link. That is second link, third link, and fourth link. Now we have to locate all the instantaneous center. So step one, so here number of link is 4. So for this we have to take small n equal to 4. So therefore number of instantaneous center capital N equal to n minus 1 divided by 2. So from this we can find total number of instantaneous center. So here small n equal to 4. So put the value, all value in this equation, 4 into bracket 4 minus 1 divided by 2 equal to 6. Means we have capital N equal to 6. Means we have to locate 6 instantaneous center in this problem. Step 2, 4-bar mechanism, there are the 6 instantaneous center. So therefore these centers are listed as shown in the table. So now we locate all the centers. So this is link 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 instantaneous center. I will share easy trick so you can understand very easily. So here you can see this is link number 1, means this is 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4. The 1 is common. We cannot put 1, 1, but we can put 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Now go for second link. So it may be first 2, 1 that already listed. So not mentioned, 2, 2 is not allowable, 2, 3 and 2, 4 is possible. Now 4 link 3, 3, 1 is already listed, 3, 2 is already listed. So we can, 3, 3 is not possible and 3, 4 is mentioned here, that is 3, 4. So you can count that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. We have to locate this all the 6 centers on the 4-bar chain mechanism. Now step 3, locate the fixed and permanent instantaneous center, that is 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 1, 4. Here you can see this is 1, 2. So here link number 1, and link number 2. So you can locate this center here, I12. Now 23, here you can see this is link number 2 and link number 3. So at this point you can plot institutional center I23. Now 34, here you can see this is link number 3, link number 4. So at this point you can locate that institutional center 34 and 14. So this is link number 1 and 4 intersect here. So this is institutional center point I14. So we have already located fixed and permanent centers on this figure, that is I12, 23, 34 and I14. So two institutional centers are remaining, that is I13 and 24. Now step number 4, locate the remaining neither fixed or nor permanent institutional center by Enerhall-Kennedy theorem. So this is a very easy theorem, you can understand very easily by seeing this video. So mark the 4 points like this, make one circle random radius and mark 4 points, that is point 1, 2, 3 and 4 on the circle. Step 5, join this 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1 and indicate the intersectional center that already located, that is I12, I23, I34 and I14. So this method is called Enerhall-Kennedy theorem. So link number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now step number 6, join this 1 and 3. Join this 1 and 3 and make two triangle, that is 1, 2, 3 and 3, 4, 1. Like this, you can see here. So this is link number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Join simple 1 and 3. So make two triangles, that is triangle 1, 2, 3 and triangle 3, 4, 1. In this side, 1, 3 is common. In the both triangle side, 1, 3 is common. So therefore, institutional center I13 lies on the intersection of the lines of joining point I12 and I23. So understand here, this is a triangle 1, 3, 4. So I13 is common. So we can take I14 and I34 in the triangle 1, 3, 4. And in triangle 1, 2, 3, I13 is common. So we can take I12 and I23. So here you can see it would be I12, 23. So find out that I12 and I23. So extend this line like this and another center, that is I14 and I34. Here you can see that I14 and I34. So extend this line like this. So that will be intersect here and that is our fifth institutional center point I13. So you can see we already locate 5 centers. Now final center is remaining, that is 24. So here step number 7, join this 224 from that, make two triangle, that is 234 and I124. Now in this figure you can see join this 224, here you can see this is 224, two triangle, that is 234 and 124. But remember this thing, the side 24 is common for both the triangles. Therefore, institutional center I24 lies on the intersection of the line of joining two points. Here you can see in this triangle 2, 3, 4, 2, 4 is common. So another two point, that is I23 and 34. I23 and I34. And in triangle 1, 2, 4, 2, 4 is common. So point I12 and I14. Here you can see. So thus the center I24 is located. Now see in this figure. So I23 and I34 means extend this line like this and I12 and I14 here. This is I12 and I14 means extend this line. So at the intersect of this line, we can get our final point, that is I24. Instruction center 6 point I24, this is 6 link. We also find the value of angular velocity of link BC, that is omega BC. So since B is also a point of link BC, therefore velocity of point B on the link BC, that is VB, equal to omega BC into I13 into B. So here, by the measurement of I13B, here you can see that I13B is 500 mm. So that convert into meter, that is 0.5 meter. So omega BC equal to VB divided by I13 into B. We already find that velocity of B value, that is 3.141 divided by that value 0.5 meter. So we can simplify angular velocity of BC equal to 6.282 radian per second. So friends, this is the end of this video. If you find any query, any doubt, you can contact me or inbox me for the query. Thank you.